India is on the moon.
You've probably heard the incredible news by now. India has pulled off a world-first moon landing. After more than 14 long years of determined effort, the Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO, finally achieved their goal when their Chandrayaan 3 spacecraft gently touched down near the lunar South Pole. As the control room erupted in joyful celebration, India cemented its place in the history books as the first nation to land on the moon's mysterious South Pole.
You chose a place where no one has landed before, and that's the South Polar region of the moon.
This is a really big deal, because the South Pole is totally unexplored territory. No one has tried landing there before due to the extreme freezing temperatures and treacherous craters shrouded in permanent darkness. But India was brave enough to take the risky plunge, and it paid off. Now the door is wide open to make all kinds of new discoveries on the lunar far side. Who knows what surprises Chandrayaan 3 will uncover in the South Pole's shadows? Join us as we explore India's history-making Chandrayaan 3 mission and what secrets it could uncover on the lunar South Pole. India's fascination with Earth's natural satellite began back in 2008 when they launched their very first lunar probe named Chandrayaan 1. Right after liftoff, the spacecraft made a water-cooled discovery. It detected signs of water molecules across the moon's surface. This shocking finding suggested our dusty old moon could actually support life, and maybe even future astronaut bases. After closer study, Chandrayaan 1's water discovery was confirmed, proving our knowledge of the moon was still woefully incomplete. What could the presence of water on the moon signify for future exploration? How might this change our understanding of Earth's natural satellite? This breakthrough fueled ISRO's hunger to keep unlocking the moon's mysteries. But more than 14 long, difficult years passed before their next lunar mission blasted off. Chandrayaan 2, finally launched in 2019, carrying India's hopes of achieving a soft moon landing. Tragically, their lander Vikram crashed during descent, abruptly ending the mission. Young Indian engineers shed tears seeing their hard work literally crash and burn. It was a tough pill to swallow, but ISRO vowed to learn from this heartbreak and try again. Could Vikram's failure be a minor setback or a major roadblock for India's lunar dreams? After picking up the pieces, ISRO spent years working tirelessly to fix issues and redesign Chandrayaan 3. It wasn't easy overcoming this devastating disappointment on top of other obstacles faced over the past 14 years. Russia unexpectedly pulled out of providing the lander, leaving ISRO little time to develop it themselves. Funding challenges were a constant battle, with ISRO's budget a fraction of NASA's. A few critics slammed the mission as a waste of limited money. And when one professor dared predict failure, he was swiftly punished. Through it all, ISRO never lost hope. Their perseverance finally paid off with Chandrayaan 3's epic South Pole landing. This mysterious region at the bottom of the moon is freezing cold and cloaked in darkness, with unknown hazards below. No one had risked trying to land there before, but ISRO knew the risky attempt could pay off big. Ancient ice deposits could be locked in the South Pole's permanently shadowed craters, and with ice comes the possibility of water, and maybe even life. So India took a daring moonshot by targeting the uncharted South Pole. When Chandrayaan 3 touched down intact, India cemented its place in history as the first nation to land near the lunar South Pole. Take that, NASA and Russia! India accomplished what even the Americans couldn't for a shockingly low price tag of $77 million. Compare that to the US spending over $150 billion on Apollo. With modest means but mighty determination, ISRO won this round of the new space race. This victory opens up exciting possibilities for the future, with NASA keen to partner up on studying the lunar South Pole. The success of Chandrayaan 3 proves India has the right stuff and lays the foundations for even bolder upcoming missions. ISRO plans to land rovers by the South Pole in search of resources like buried ice or minerals that could sustain a future moon base. And by bringing back the first ever samples from the South Pole, India could uncover clues about the moon's mysterious past and future. Will there be signs of water or even ancient microfossils in those moon rocks? Only time and further exploration will tell. What secrets might the South Pole still hold for India and ISRO to uncover? India's triumphant Chandrayaan 3 moon landing underscores how far their space program has come. Older generations would be amazed to see India now leading lunar exploration. Back in the 1980s, India's first space launch attempts ended in failure and ridicule. Their early rockets kept blowing up, earning unflattering nicknames like Ocean of Fire from frustrated scientists. But the country refused to give up on their space dreams. After decades of laying the groundwork, the Chandrayaan missions are the hard-won payoff. India went from launching tiny-sounding rockets in the 60s and 70s to putting a craft on the moon's south pole in 2023. It took a lot of patience, learning from mistakes and building upon successes, like India's first Mars orbiter, Mangalyaan. Now, India's space agency has truly arrived onto the global stage. The tremendous challenge of this moon landing cannot be overstated. It's an enormously complex process where the slightest glitch can spell disaster. Look how many missions have crashed into the lunar surface over the decades, including Israel's Bereshit lander just last year. India also faced the added difficulty of aiming for the risky South Pole, unlike any previous landing. It would have been easy to write off ISRO's ambitions as impossible, but they believed in their abilities. In the tense days leading up to touchdown, the whole world watched and waited in suspense. The 14-year journey all came down to these crucial moments. ISRO engineers held their breath as the lander hurtled towards its target, relying on years of calculation and planning. Then came confirmation of landing success, and relief washed over mission control. India had stuck the landing against tough odds, silencing the naysayers. With Chandrayaan 3's against-the-odds success, India has gained a massive boost in credibility as an emerging space superpower. Their historic moon landing proves that with enough patience and persistence, giant leaps are possible, even with limited resources. The entire world celebrates their inspirational achievement. We can't wait to see what surprises India uncovers on the lunar far side. By venturing where no one has gone before, India is opening up an exciting new chapter of lunar discovery. One thing is for sure, the moon has even more secrets left to reveal, and ISRO has proven they have the skills and daring spirit to uncover them. What do you think of this discovery made by India? Let us know down in the comments. Until next time!